Now, Philippine officials say the U.S. Navy has yet to submit any concrete plans for the removal of the USS Guardian from the Tubbataha Reef. Meanwhile, the Tubbataha Management Office has come up with a creative way to raise funds to help shoulder expenses caused by the grounding incident. Let's get the details from Jeff Canoy.
The U.S. Navy has been present in meetings at the command center of the Task Force Tubbataha in Palawan. But it has been tight-lipped on the grounding incident these past few days. It's been 12 days since the USS Guardian ran aground at the Tubbataha Reef. According to Philippine officials, the U.S. Navy has not yet submitted a detailed plan or timetable on when and how it will remove the grounded ship from the site.
Wala pa silang final plan at iniintay namin yung kanilang presentation ng salvage plan.
So far, all the U.S. Navy has done is to defuel and take out heavy equipment from the ship in preparation for its removal from the World Heritage Site.
We would like to do this as fast as we can, but there are some factors now which affects the pace of the operation.
Each day the USS Guardian remains on the reef, the expenses incurred by the Tubbataha Management Office because of the grounding go up. The office is even changing the logo for its 25th anniversary to include a picture of the grounded vessel. They plan to sell t-shirts to raise funds.
Now we're using more fuel, we're using more time, we're using more communications. All of this costs money, and we need to find that money somewhere.
Task Force Tubbataha says they have not yet discussed whether the United States will be made to pay for expenses of the Philippine Coast Guard and the Philippine Navy. Meanwhile, women's group Gabriela staged a protest in front of the U.S. Embassy in Manila Tuesday. The group describes as rape the damage caused by the grounding of the USS Guardian. Jeff Canoy, ABS-CBN News, Palawan.